This is not clickbait. I really mean when I say this podcast episode has impacted the way I perceive life, business, relationships, and making money. Let me show you exactly what this podcast episode is, and I want every single one of you listeners to listen to it completely and then let me know in the comments, has it impacted your own mindset? Okay, with that said, let's get started with today's video. All right, now this podcast episode was released by Naval. If you don't already know, Naval Ravikant is actually the co-founder of AngelList, and he is also an investor. He has invested in some of the biggest tech companies that you can imagine, right? He has invested in Twitter, he has invested in Uber as well. And the name of this podcast episode is How to Get Rich. And it is a huge 3.5 hour long podcast episode, right? So this podcast episode was actually based upon his Twitter storm, which says how to get rich without getting lucky. And I think that a lot of people, whenever they see someone who is rich, they have two perceptions about them. Number one, they either got lucky, or number two, they scam people somehow, right? So there's this evil mentality that we have that if someone is rich, they have to be evil in some form or manner, right? So that is what he wanted to dismiss. And in this Twitter storm, he has explained exactly that. He says how to get rich without getting lucky. And after that, he has a lot of amazing tweets that I would encourage all of you to take a look at. Now in the podcast episode that I'm talking about, that podcast episode is where he elaborates on every single one of these tweets. Okay, so there are a ton of tweets over here. The one that I like the most is the one that says you will never get rich by renting out your time. You need to own an equity, a piece of business that can create wealth for you when you are asleep, right? Another one that I like a lot is this one. It says seek wealth, not money or status. Wealth is having assets that earn while you sleep. Money is how we transfer time and wealth, and status is your place in the social hierarchy. So true. All of these tweets are just really amazing. Understand that ethical wealth creation is possible. If you secretly despise wealth, it will elude you. Completely agree with that. This tweet is actually for people who want to start their own startup. This is what they should be aiming for. You will get rich by giving society what it wants but doesn't know how to get it at scale, right? This is so true. If you want to make something valuable to people, make something that they really want to use but don't know how to get it, right? They don't exactly know the path. That is what Steve Jobs did with the Apple iPhone. That is what Uber did. That is what all of the most successful startups did. I also like one more tweet, which is out of this storm, and it says basically the internet makes it possible for 8 billion monopolies to exist. That one is just amazing. Play iterated games. All the returns in life, whether in wealth, relationships, or knowledge, comes from compound interest. I am just blown away by just reading this. Every single day I take a look at this and I'm just like, oh my God, this is just amazing stuff, you know. This one is also really amazing. It says, learn to sell, learn to build. If you can do both, you will be unstoppable. If you can learn how to code and how to create some application, and you can also learn how to sell it to someone, there you go, there you have it, right? That is all that you need. You need, first of all, to create it and then how to sell it properly. If you can do both, that is just really incredible. Arm yourself with specific knowledge, accountability, and leverage. Then it says specific knowledge is knowledge that you cannot be trained for. If the society can train you, it can train someone else and replace you. This is so true. You want to do something that is specific and that cannot be copied easily, right? Let's say you're only working as a data entry officer or something. You can very well be replaced, right? Because that skill anyone can have. So because of that, anyone can replace you. So there's no point in learning something like that. You need to learn something that people cannot easily copy, right? That would make you unique, that would make you specific and irreplaceable actually. This one is really insightful. It basically says, give me a lever long enough and place to stand and I will move the earth. This is basically him referring to leverage and how important leverage is, right? If you take a look at Aman Dhatarwal, whatever he says gets spread to every single person. So currently he's doing an amazing job helping every single person. So every single person is enjoying and he has that huge impact that was only made possible because of his huge audience. And I would really encourage all of you to take a look at all of these tweets in a Twitter storm and then also listen to the podcast episodes. He talks a lot about, you know, starting a business, coming up with an idea, and just how to operate startups, as well as he talks about business and how to choose a co-founder. Then he talks about just wealth inequality that we have in this world. And then he also talks about philosophy and reading books and a lot of other things, right? He really has helped me think about life in a different perspective. I used to listen every single day when I was about to go to dinner. Okay, so I would be eating and I would be listening to his conversation with his co-founder from AngelList. Okay, so both of them are just talking about life, you know, how to create wealth. And that is what he's talking about. He's talking about leverage and how can you create leverage, different forms of leverage that exist in this world. And I would really encourage all of you to take a look at this. I know I'm repeating it again and again, but I strongly believe that if you can just listen to this complete podcast episode, you will get a different mentality. It is available on YouTube. Take a look at it. I will link it in the description so you can have a listen to that. It is a long one. It is like 3.5 hours long, but it is so worth it, right? I have listened to it 2 or 3 times right now, the same recording again and again, and I always get some new insight from that one. Okay, I have even created this carousel on my own Instagram handle wherein I'm talking about 8 of the best insights that I have gotten from listening to this complete podcast episode. I would highly encourage you to take a look at that carousel as well. Right, guys, so this person is just amazing. The way he thinks about life and creating wealth is just incredible. He has also been on the Joe Rogan Experience, so I would highly encourage you to watch that one as well. And yeah, I mean, he has done an amazing job of just exploring new fields, right? He's a big believer into Bitcoin, and he also does like to read a lot of books. So yeah, that has been pretty much it. I know this was a short video, but I wanted to make this quick video to tell you about something that has really changed my perception about life and, you know, just career in general. Take a look at this. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure that you share this video with your friends. Tell everyone else about this amazing 3-hour long podcast episode and just share it with others. And let me know in the comment section below which one insight have you gotten from the complete video, right? Or from the complete podcast episode. Take a look at that. And yeah, guys, thank you so much. Subscribe to this channel, like this video, and I will see you all in the next video. Bye-bye.